What's up, Warrior Nation? I'm Hunter, and this is the last Friday before a well-deserved fall break. We have a lot of fun waiting for us today. We'll unpack the world of fall break and see what people are doing to enjoy their time off. Then we'll show the vital information on how to apply to colleges and the benefits applying has for students looking to further their education. Lastly, we're going to reconvene with the possibility of not having any more pep rallies and see how we did this year. Hopefully, we had a packed house cheering on their school spirit. We got all that and more right here on the Friday Show. This week dives into the plans of what people are doing for fall break. With 2 whole weeks off, I feel like we have enough time to travel around the world. Colin Blazik and Jonathan Garski go around school to get the full scoop on ideas and plans for fall break 2019.
Hi, this is Colton with Warrior TV News, and today we'll be going around interviewing people, asking them what they're doing for fall break.
I am working on my dissertation at IU. It's a big research project.
Chilling out, maxing, relaxing all cool, and I'll shoot some b-ball outside of the school.
All you know, man. Going.
I'm just here so I don't get fined.
What are you guys doing over the fall break?
I am going to Orlando, Florida.
Hang out with the boys, watch some football, the usual.
Gonna go visit my friends in Bloomington, hang out with them.
Watch football, be lazy.
The best time of our lives out here. Shout out to Colton, giving me the microphone out here.
A lot of NFL and a lot of Guitar Hero.
You know, we're just roaming around the WCHS halls out here. Looking to have a great fall break, you know.
Basketball. Yes, the first week I have volleyball and the second week I have basketball.
Only, what, 7 school days left? You know? I mean, let's just have a great fall break, make the best of it.
Red River Gorge in Kentucky, and we're doing an underwater cave kayak tour.
Mostly I'm staying home, but I'm going to Chicago for a few days.
I am attempting to earn a doctorate at IU, and I have to write chapter 4 of my dissertation.
With Jonathan Garski, Warrior TV News.
Go White and Warriors.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks, guys. What does Maxon even mean? Must be a 90s reference. Our next segment covers a topic that some students dread, the next step in life. That step most of the time is college, but college doesn't come without getting accepted. Accepted proceeds the application process, which can be the biggest challenge an anxious form to fill out. Haley Wingo and Bryce Hughes uncover the steps and ways to go about filling out the college application and next steps to our education.
Many seniors are in the middle of applying to their dream colleges and spending hours writing essays and filling out the FAFSA. College application time can be a stressful but rewarding time for students.
I would suggest that college-bound students apply before November 1st, if at all possible. That's the priority deadline, meaning that if they get their applications in before that date, colleges will look at their GPAs, SAT scores, ACT scores, and possibly earn scholarships just based on those scores and GPAs.
Currently, I've applied to I'm in the process of four. I've already got accepted to three of them. I may apply to one or two more just because I want to leave my options open so that in the near future I won't regret not applying.
There were actually a lot of places that I wanted to apply to, but I already had a full ride scholarship to UIndy if I chose to go there. It did take a little while. On the first day of school, I went to McMillan and got my transcripts from him, and then after that, he sent them in and I got the college the acceptance letter back maybe like 2 weeks later.
Fall break is a great time for students to either go on college visits or complete those college applications. They have 2 weeks where they can work on essays and get those applications submitted.
Some of them are a little longer than others, but most of them aren't necessarily difficult. You kind of just have to know what activities you did, what your grades were. Always fill out your FAFSA, but that's about it.
I think it is stressful. There's a lot that goes into it. Some applications are very simple and they're free. Some applications take letters of recommendation. Sometimes they take essays. Sometimes there's fees attached to them. So it can be a stressful time, which is why we want you guys to start early.
It was actually a pretty easy process. It didn't cost any money, and it was pretty speedy. There were a couple short answer questions, but not like a long essay.
Any internships can always help you in the future because it means that employers and stuff will look at you more qualified and know that you're able to go into a professional workplace and do what you're supposed to.
No, if they apply after November 1st, they can still apply to different scholarships and they may meet the need-based scholarships, but as far as merit-based, they might miss out on some of those before November 1st. But after that, they can still apply to a lot of different scholarships, and there's still a lot of different scholarship opportunities after that time.
As many seniors already know, applying to college can be very time-consuming, but also extremely rewarding. If you have any questions about applying to college, please contact your counselor for assistance. I'm Haley, here with Bryce, Warrior TV News.
I'm so thankful for those two, because I'm looking at the application now, and whoa, I'm gonna need all of fall break to figure this thing out. Seniors, application deadlines are vastly approaching, so get yours done and fill out the FAFSA. Nothing like free money from the government. Our last topic of conversation revisits the idea of no longer hosting pep rallies. With so many checkouts, admins was forced upon the idea of axing the old tradition to keep kids in school. Addie Carpenter and Alyssa Manis head back to last week's pep rally and homecoming to deliver some exciting times and hopefully a successful event.
The last time we talked about the pep rally and all the activities that go along with it, it was a very sore subject. Today, we are going to go back and look at all the memories from homecoming 2019 in the pep rally and see all the happy memories that came along with it this year.
Thank you.
Warriors. From what we just saw right there, I think everyone had such a great time from this past week celebrating homecoming and everything that comes along with it. I think that there might be a chance pep rallies are not being canceled. Not even close, not even an idea.
Awesome job, guys. It looks like we may have just another year of the pep rally. Well, that's about all the time we have for this week's edition of the Friday Show. I'm not going to waste any more time, because fall break is just around the corner. Remember, students, be safe, have fun, and most importantly, just enjoy the time away from school. We'll see you in a few weeks, Warrior Nation. Go Warriors!